Only you, Jesus, my strong tower. Only you will I run
in times of my trouble.
You are
my rock, my father, defense of my trouble.
Oh yeah,
you are my
mighty warrior, Prince of Peace, great provider. You're my strength.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. 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 Hallelujah. Beloved, good morning. How are you today and your family? I welcome you again to today's Sunday service, our last Sunday of the month Thanksgiving service. And today is the last Sunday of the month of May. It's usually our Thanksgiving Sunday. As for, I'd like us to lift up our voice wherever we are in order to appreciate God for making me and you to see the last Sunday in the month of May. He brought us forth from January, February, March, April, May. We have seen the last Sunday of May today. I'm well persuaded that if you can see the last Sunday of May today, you will surely see the last Sunday of the next month, the last Sunday of this year 2020, in the mighty name of Jesus. But before we pray, I want you to please share, invite families and friends. I want you to tag somebody on your Facebook. I want you to share this transmission on the watch party. And I want you to invite your family and your friends. One more time, my name is Dr. Taru, and I am the Senior Pastor of Worship Water Ministry International South Africa in Johannesburg. I bring you special greeting from all our family, all our families internationally. I want you to know that as you are hooked to our transmission, you are already a part of this family. So anytime, any day, you are welcome into our ministry. Lift up your voice right now and let's just appreciate God for today's service and for the end of the month. Father, we appreciate you today. We glorify your name for what you have been doing since the beginning of the month. Thank you for a prophetic watch over us. Thank you for Shekinah glory over our life. Thank you for all our families. Thank you for our career. Thank you for our ministry. We thank you for everything. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you, Lord, for sparing us against the coronavirus. Thank you for saving us against any attack of enemy or any satanic attack in our life, in our family. We glorify your name. Thank you, Lord, for making us to see the end of this month. Thank you, because we know you will surely make us to see the end of the new month and the end of the year in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we glorify your name. We magnify your name. Thank you, Spirit of the Lord. Thank you, Spirit of the Lord, for what you are doing and what you are about to do in this service today. We invite you, Holy Spirit, come into our midst right now. Come into our midst, O Lord. Let your Spirit saturate the city. Let your Spirit saturate the atmosphere. Saturate our home and everywhere people are hearing us right now in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Beloved, I have a special message for you this morning. I have a very special message for you. Hear me, I'm on a journey since the beginning of this month, last month, or since the lockdown, global lockdown has begun. I'm on a special spiritual journey. And God has been teaching me and has been showing me the new dispensation world. The new dispensation world that we are going to experience and we are going to encounter after this lockdown, after the pandemic, global lockdown. It's a new experience. And I've been teaching you, and I'm going to still teach you again today what you have never heard, what you will hardly hear by any minister of gospel. This is the true, this is the reality of the present situation that nobody might or may be able to come boldly to speak to us, particularly from different altar. So God has given me this assignment in order to break the yoke of silence by which many of us have been subjected to for so many years. And with this coronavirus or the global lockdown has opened our eyes to see. So listen to me, my brethren. This is a true teaching. This is not a motivational word. I want to assure you, this is not a motivational word at all, but it is an edification and it is modificational teaching. It will change your life positively forever if you care to listen and to follow me in this journey. At the end of this journey, I'm sure you will be able to come out as yourself. You'll be able to come out as yourself. If there's anybody hearing me now that has been lost, or you don't know that you have been lost in the world for many years, this is the time for you to realize who you are in the Lord, in the world, and in the words of God. So join me again this morning as the Lord asked me to speak on a specific title, on a specific subject, which is titled Facing Your Present Situation in Actualizing Your Destination. So again, the subject, the title of my teaching today that the Lord has laid into my heart to speak to you is titled Facing Your Present Situation in Actualizing Your Destination. Do you have a destination? Do you know where you are going in life? Where are you going in life? Where do you want to be in life? Where are you now? Where are you coming from? Before the global lockdown, every one of us has been doing everything, anything, anyhow, carelessly. But after this global lockdown, we have been able to encounter a new world system that we have never imagined that we are going to face. Therefore, I'm asking you again, if you are listening to me right now, where are you going? Do you have a destination? As a businessman, as a ministry, as a family man or family woman, as a single man, as a single woman, as a student, as a career person, if you are under the sound of my voice, ask yourself or ask somebody next to you, where are you going in life? What do you want to be? Right now, we have seen a new order. We have encountered a break in our aspiration. Down the line, 3 months or 4 months down the line, all of us have seen a break that is called the lockdown. So, in view of the break that you have encountered, I don't know what are the effects that you have experienced. I don't know what has been the advert effect of this lockdown in your life. So that brings me to that same question. Where are you going in life? What is your destination? Everyone hearing me now, let me ask you some questions. And I'm going to be asking you some questions in order for you, in order for me to be able to help you, in order for me to be able to help you in actualizing your destination in view of the present situation. Now, I'm going to be asking you some questions. My teaching today is going to be an interactive session, and I want you to follow me in this journey in order for all of us to get to somewhere where we'll be able to learn something today. Right now, the first question I'm going to ask you is, where is your life presently now? Where is your life? Are you happy about your life? Just examine some area of your life right now. Are you happy? Financially, are you happy? Spiritually, are you fulfilled? Medically, are you happy? Where is your life presently now? As of today, despite the global lockdown or your country lockdown, your business, your career, your study lockdown, where are you? My question to you is, where are you at the moment right now? Are you happy? Are you happy at the moment right now? Yes or no? Yes or no? Now, I want to ask you a second question. Are you depressed or are you sad or are you confused today? Because if your answer is yes or if your answer is no, particularly if your answer is no, that makes me to wonder if you are actually happy now. Or are you depressed now? Or are you confused of what next? Now, let's go together again. Another question I want to ask you is, are you just unsure where you are now? Some people just say, well, I'm not really sad, yet I'm not happy. That means, are you unsure where you are now? Are you unsure of tomorrow? And are you unsure of your business survival? Are you unsure of your job? Are you unsure of your work? Are you unsure? You are not sure of your ministry. You are not even sure of your career. You are not sure anymore. What's going to happen tomorrow? Tomorrow is the 1st of June. Congratulations, for example, in South Africa, we are entering the third level of the lockdown. But many of us that are hearing me now, you are definitely even not unsure. You are not even sure whether your own company will be allowed to operate, or even when you are operating, when you'll be operating tomorrow, you are not sure whether you are going to still get the job when you get back to the office tomorrow. These are the kind of people I want to talk to, and I welcome you to this platform this moment. My fourth question is, be honest to you at this moment, where are you standing economically, spiritually, medically, and physically now? Where are you standing? Would you be able to say you are standing very well economically? Would you be able to say you are standing well spiritually? Would you be able to say you are standing well medically? And would you be able to say, yes, I'm standing well physically? What has happened or what has been happening in your life for some months now that everything has been on the lockdown? How can you then arrive at your destination in this present situation? Beloved, I'm asking you in general. For example, again, let me ask you, where is your relationship? Where is your marriage? Where is your spouse? Where are your best friends? What is happening in your life? Generally, my sister and my brother, some people cannot say this is exactly what is happening in their life. That takes me to another question, beloved. What is your hope? Do you actually have hope in your business, in your career, in your ministry? In so many things that you have not been able to do for the past 3 or 4 months that we have been on a lockdown. Do you really have hope? How big is your hope? Or how thin is your hope, or are your hope? And takes me to ask you another question, beloved. Are you very certain, or are you sure of your tomorrow's success and breakthrough again? Can you be boastful? Can you be boastful? Are you boastful as you are hearing me now of tomorrow? Maybe I'm asking you again. Have you seen your business or yourself going backward or being stagnated in view of the recent lockdown? My brother, my sister, I'm asking you again. Are you very weak? Are you tired? Or are you now losing hope in everything or in one part of your life? Okay, wait a minute before you give up or before you appraise yourself. Just give me a minute before you appraise yourself or before you give up today. I want you firstly to give thanks to God for everything. For the Bible says, in all things, giving thanks. In all things, giving thanks. I don't know how sad you have been. I don't know how all those questions I've asked you have affected you, negatively or positively. First thing I want us to do right now is lift up your voice to just say, Father, I thank you. Thank you for everything that is happening in my life. I know and I know that you are still God and you will always be God. Thank you. Thank you for everything. Thank you that I'm not in the grave today. Thank you that I'm still alive. For there is life and there is hope for them that are still joined to the living. Lord, I glorify your name and magnify your name in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now, let me go now back to your situation, my situation, our present situation, and how can we face the present situation in actualizing or in getting to our destination. Now, the first thing you must learn to realize in any present situation where you are now is, are you facing the reality of the present situation that you are in now? Are you facing the reality? How sure or how well are you be able to absorb this reality? I want you to listen to this, my brother and my sister. Success and achievement in life, or failure and rejection in life, is not how far you have been in the wrong decision, or it's not how far you have been living a false life and chasing shadows in life, but how you can stand up and how you can make a U-turn and facing the reality of your present situation. I'm repeating myself. Success and achievement in life, or failure and rejection in life, they are not how far you have been in the wrong decision. It's not how far you have been in the wrong decision that you've been failing or the people have been rejecting you. It's not far. It's not how far you have been on that wrong path, but how fast you can make a U-turn, or how fast you can face the reality of your situation. Your success or your failure is not how far you have gone, but how far you will be able to take a reality, face a reality. Tell yourself, I am poor. Tell yourself, I am weak. If you are able to face the reality, then you are about to face a new beginning. You are about to face a turnaround in your situation and your circumstances. Remember, people of the Lord, what does the word of God do in our life? When we gather like this, the word of God in our life is to enhance your spirit being. Is to challenge your spirit being in order to discover yourself. The word of God is like a medicine to our spirit, souls, and mind in challenging every deadly situation in our circumstances. So therefore, again, I want to teach you some realities of life. If you are ready. People of God, there is a message God is sending me to tell the whole world. And that message is the message of reality. The message of reality is the message we have never been hearing on our altar before now. This message is the new word of life. And it's a message we must all engage, we must all examine, whether it is be true or whether it is being false. What is this new word I'm talking about, beloved? I'm talking about facing your present situation in actualizing your destination. Listen to me, people of God. The new word that can make all of us to overcome the COVID-19 effect and move forward quickly is simply by facing the reality and the truth of the present situation. I'm going to read my first scripture right now. The Bible says, "For you shall know the truth, and the truth you know shall set you free." John chapter 8 verse 32. You shall know the truth. That means you shall face the reality. What is the truth? The reality of the matter. You shall know the truth. The reality. And the reality that you face, that you know. He said, well, it will set you free. Many of us, we are not set free. We are on our safe prison because we have refused to face reality. We have refused to tell ourselves the truth. So, the time has come for all of us to face the new world circumstances and to deliver ourselves from the whole world illusion and sentimentalism. Spiritually, medically, physically, politically, and mentally. This is the time for every one of us to face reality in every aspect of our life. Spiritually, physically, medically, mentally. Why? Why do we have to face reality in all this aspect? Because we have all lived, let me tell you the truth, we have all lived and we have been living many years back since we were born in so many fake life. We have been living in so many deception life, wicked and hypocrisy lifestyle. We have all failed to face the reality of the earth and the heaven. We have all failed. Many years back, since I was born, since you were born, in this generation, we have all failed to face the realities of the earth and of the heavens. Hence, we have all been living so many years in fake life, deception life. We have all been living in wicked and hypocrisy lifestyle because we have all failed to face the reality of the earth. But now, somebody say, but now. Say, but now. It is time for every one of us to embrace the new ways, the new world order, which I describe as a new world reality. And this new world reality was as a result of our present encounter discovery in this global COVID-19 pandemic lesson. So again, beloved, hearing me, I want to ask you some more questions. As I told you that this is an interactive section today and in all the subsequent meetings, I don't want to be the only one talking. I want to hear from you. I want to share with you so that we will be able to get our destination. Now, the question I want to ask you, which is like the eighth question, is: have you learned anything from your own country lockdown situation? Personally, have you yourself hearing me now? Have you learned anything? Has anything occurred to you? Have you learned any lesson since the lockdown began? I ask you, have you learned anything? Are you still asking? Or some of us, we are still asking ourselves right now, why did God allow COVID-19 encounter to his children? Some of us, maybe we are still asking this question. But why did God allow COVID-19 to happen? Or maybe some of us, you are hearing me now, maybe you are still being deceived by many prophets, many apostles and pastors that claim we got anointing power over COVID-19 global pandemics. Maybe some of us are still in that position asking ourselves questions. Maybe I'm also asking that question. Maybe I'm also one of them. Maybe we have deceived you. Maybe I have deceived you that I've got anointing power, I've got an anointing oil, I've got a power over COVID-19 global pandemics. So if I've got power over, or if they of prophet, pastors, president, likewise medical personnel before now, have claimed that we got power over COVID-19 global pandemic. Now, the question is this: why have we not been able to cure it immediately? Reality. So don't let somebody sit down there on the internet, in the four corners of his room now, social media, that he got a power, he got anointing to heal. I don't say there is no healing, don't get me right, but I'm asking you, have you subjected this kind of this such presentation to reality? Or are you still in the denial of the past, that people can just come to you and say, we are doing this and we can do this, we can do that? Now, let me help you to answer this question by further questions. Did God not aware of Job's persecutions? Yes or no? Did God not allow Job persecution? When Satan went to God, he said, God, this is your son that are claiming that they are prophets, they are children of God, they are this, they are this, they are that, they are righteous. Let me prove to you that this one, they will deny you. I want to liken the present situation in reality to Job encounter. Did God not aware? Job was God in God's heart, a righteous man that chose righteousness. Why should God allow persecution to happen to Job? I'm going to show you at the end of this, in the course of this meeting, why. Why would God allow COVID-19 lockdown globally? So why should God allow righteous men to fall in temptation? Number two, I want to ask you a question in order to answer my question. Was God not aware of Noah's wide water destruction? Who instructed Noah? Stay indoor. Noah, go inside the ark, because I want to create a new world. And Noah proclaimed the word to the nation. How many listening? Was Noah not preserved because he listened? He obeyed the lockdown. What happened after Noah? He came out to be who? He came out to be the man that the global world are still celebrating today. So I want you to know, people of God, here, that despite the global lockdown, you and I will still be men and women to be celebrated after this event. Now, I want to ask you, was God not aware of Jesus' crucifixion? Was God not aware? Why was Jesus crucified? Why? Because the scripture will be fulfilled. If when Jesus said, oh, Father, my Father, my Father, have thou forsaken me? God said, my son, the scripture must be fulfilled. In order for you to have them that is above for the names. God didn't stop him that day. God didn't stop the crucifixion that day. In order for his scripture and for the power of God to be manifested. So that's why I'm beginning to know that God was aware of COVID-19 situation. Why did God allow it? If God was aware of God, and there's nothing that happened on this earth that God did not aware, people of the Lord. Didn't God have the power to scatter the conspiracy theory? Even where and when it was being originated? God has the power. Brother, I want you to know again that there is nothing happen or that will happen on this earth and in the world that God is not aware of. You know why? Because his name is Alpha and Omega. Because he is the omnipresent and omniscience. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is a miracle working God. He knows the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic, the conspiracy. He knew the end. But now, why should God allow COVID-19 pandemic global lockdown? Four reasons. Listen to me. I've been saying it and I will say it again. Four reasons. Number one, in order to expose men's wickedness to each other. Because COVID-19, whether we like it or not, is not the heart of God. It's the heart of man. The wickedness of men to each other. Number two, God allowed it in order to humble the arrogant nation, arrogancy of men. arrogancy of men. Number three, God allowed this situation in order to search the heart of men towards him. The same way Job was attacked, God allowed it in order to seek the heart of Job towards him. Number four, hear me. God allowed it to happen in order to promote and create a new man identity. This is very interesting. In order what to create a new man identity. You have seen and we have seen that there is a new global identity. God needed to change the government identity, show government political leader true color. Their mistake, their wrongs, the inequality between the poor and the rich in the whole global world. God needed to search the heart of men. The wicked one has been exposed now. The evil one has been exposed. What you really say, Father, thank you for this COVID-19? Because it has made me to discover who I am. It has made you to discover who you are. It has made you to discover the government, the community, and everything around we may never have known on the days to come. So these are some of the benefits or the reason why God allowed COVID-19. And the last one was where you should be excited. It allowed this to happen in order to promote and create new men identity. We have seen the new things happening right now that would never have been there since the beginning of 2020, if there was no this COVID-19 situation. Government is looking after people right now. People are looking after people right now. Yet also, we have been so right now, there is a new world. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10 says, after that you have suffered a little while, it was a little while, he said, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, confirm, strengthen, and establish you. That's what we are going through right now. So I don't want you to give up. The reality of COVID-19 is that God wants to promote and create a new identity. After that, we have suffered a while. He will change us. He will reform us. He will establish us. God will refurbish you and will establish you from today. Because you have suffered a while. We have suffered a while. Now it's time for his purpose to be established. And I say to you, God will establish you. So now, brethren, what is the present reality world after this COVID-19 global lockdown? And after the global reopening phases? Number one, hear me. I am fully persuaded that COVID-19 is a wake-up call. It's what is a wake-up call, number one. In every area of our life, spiritually, medically, physically, mentally, psychologically, politically, it is a wake-up call. How many of you agree with me with that? Number two, COVID-19 is a world-changer power. It's a world-changer game. It's a world changer game, the global world changer game. We have seen it. And that is the changer power. Number, so for this reason, what happened to you and me in this period of the COVID-19, the changer power? Well, it's for me and you to learn and awaken our mind and brain from sleeping and deceptions of many years that we have encountered. So it's a world changer power. To adjust our way. Number three, to be promoted and be transformed. It's a world changer. For me and you to be promoted and be transformed. It's a world changer. Number four, to face reality of the world against illusion and deception. So COVID-19 is a world changer game. Why? Hear this. Because Job didn't fail in his encounter. What happened? He faced the reality of the condition. He never denied God. And what happened? He received double of everything that was lost. Game changer. You will receive double promotion, lifting of anything and everything that you must have lost during this course of global lockdown. You will receive visitation of God. What happened? When Noah confronted the situation and faced the reality, he never denied God. He never disobeyed God's instruction. Go inside. Lock yourself down. He went inside. He locked himself down. God come out from after Job and Noah. And Noah find grace. And God remember Noah. Why? Because he accepted the reality. He faced the reality. He never doubted God. Revelation chapter 3 verse 10. Hear this. Because you have kept the word of my perseverance, I also will keep you from the hour of testing. That hour which is about to come upon the whole world to test those who dwell in the earth. Maybe you don't see what I'm seeing. Our experience and our encounter of global COVID-19 lockdown was for the scripture to be fulfilled. Revelation chapter 3 verse 10 says, because you have kept the word of my perseverance for how many months? I also will keep you from the hour of testing. That hour which is about to come upon the whole world. Not one world, not one nation. The whole world, that hour with us, we have encountered, so we have experienced it now. To test those who dwell on the earth. So the scripture says in verse 22 of that book, he says, he who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the assembly or to the church of God. This is exactly what I'm telling you now. If you want to hear me. If you don't want to hear me, Noah said his own. We have gone through it. He faced the reality. Therefore, what is the truth? The truth right now is facing the reality of every situation that we have experienced and that we have encountered. We must stop living a falsehood life. We have been living a falsehood life for many years. Since I was born, I never knew that I've been living a falsehood life. You never knew that you have been living a falsehood life for many years until what you have experienced and what you have encountered during this lockdown period. So, wherever you are today, people of the Lord, hear me, is the reality of your decision yesterday. Wherever we are now, wherever the COVID-19 lockdown has met you or has met me, they are the reality of our decision. Where we are or what that we have made here before now. Beside the grace and the mercy and the favor of God upon our life, every one of us, we have find ourselves presently in our situation right now by virtue of our decision that we have made. You find yourself where you are today now, the job you are doing right now, the marriage you are in now, the relationship you are in now, the study, the career that you are in now, presently right now, they are the decision that you have made. Those decisions you have made, now the question is, was it based on reality or they were based on illusion? We have seen that now. Every person's situation we face today, they are a result of our decision we made yesterday. Or the decision somebody made for you. Is it that decision you made consciously by yourself or the decision somebody made for you? Now that we have encountered the present situation, how can I now maximize or actualize my future, my destination with the present situation? Particularly, let me tell you, in your education life, in your religion life, in your marital life, in your career life, your character, your attitude, your mentality, they are all factors of of your decision that you made yesterday. So right now, where are you today? I'm the product of you. Where are you today? They are the product of your yesterday. But now you have got another chance by yourself, and only by yourself, to take another decision by facing the realities of life. By yourself, spiritually, physically, medically, educationally, and every aspect of your life. You've got now yourself to take a new decision. COVID-19 was the world changer master game. In order for me and you to be able to take a new decision that will take me to my own destination. Yesterday, I've decided for you as a parent or as a spiritual father or as a prophet or as a pastor, they have decided everything that we were yesterday. But now, we have got the opportunity, because that was a world changer, in order for me and you to take a new decision. And that decision is what I'm telling you that is a decision of reality. It's a decision of reality. Let me tell you, people of the Lord, hearing me now. This is the time everyone must face a reality on their destiny and personal life, spiritually, physically. There is no more time to be careless and childish anymore. You got no more excuse after this game changer intervention. You've got no more excuse to blame anybody. I've got no more excuse to blame anybody. You cannot blame me for your downfall anymore. I cannot blame you for my downfall anymore or for my personal situation anymore, because I have got another opportunity in order to decide whether to follow me or to follow you or to follow God or to follow anybody. You've got that. The world, the game changer, has given us and every one of us a unique opportunity. And therefore, people of the Lord, this is the time you must wake up and take your future and your destiny in your hand. Because everyone will die alone and everyone will face the last day judgment alone. My prophet, your prophet, your pastor, your GO will not die for you. In fact, they are also waiting for judgment. We are all waiting for the judgment in that last day. When God will say, well, thank you, but I don't know you. So don't make my decision to be your decision. You've got new opportunity for you, because there is a world changer game. To face the reality. If you are still living in my own world, you are still not facing the reality of your own world. That's where I'm going. So now, what is your lesson and what is your intake spiritually? John chapter 4, verse 23, I've been preaching this. But the time is coming. Indeed, it is here now. When true worshipper will worship the Father in the spirit and in truth. So the Father is looking for those who will worship him in spirit and in truth. So we have got a world changer opportunity right now for me and you to decide who we want to worship. For 2 months, for example, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, we have not been going to the so-called building church. Maybe because somebody is coercing you, somebody is using all manner of things to entice you. But now, 2-3 months down the lane, you've got opportunity in order for you to re-examine what has been happening many years back. Sometimes, years back, maybe some pastor, your prophet, your GO keeps you in church from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 14 says, as a result, we are no longer to be children, tossed here and there by waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by the trickery of men, by craftiness in deceitful scheming. So I want you to take your spiritual journey from today based on your encounter. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 14. He said, we are no longer to be children, tossed here and there by waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by the trickeries of men, by craftiness in deceitful scheming. Verse 15 says, but speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in all aspects unto him, who is the head, even Christ. So this is your spiritual awakening. Stand for yourself and by yourself. Decide who you want to follow from this day forward. Jesus Jesus, pastor, doctrine, decide. That is a world changer opportunity for every one of us. So how many of us are ready to face the new world reality? How many of us have learned one thing or the other during the global pandemic lockdown? Have you learned anything at all? That's the question. Have you learned anything at all? If yes, what did you learn from your church, from your church member, your pastor, your papa, your mama? Did you learn anything about your parents, wife, husband, children, house people? Did you learn? Have you learned anything about your village people? Have you learned anything about your office people, your boss, your employers? What have you learned about them? What have you learned from your neighborhood, your community, your tenant, your landlord, or your landlady? Have you learned anything about him, about her? What have you learned concerning your business partner, your subscriber, and your subscription? What have you learned? Did you learn anything now about your government and political institution? Did you learn anything about your elected Mr. President, the governor, the cabinet, and the minister portfolio? What did you learn? Have you learned anything? Somebody say, yes, I've learned so many things. Okay, now, are you willing to apply your lesson to change your world and adjust spiritually, physically, and medically, politically? Are you ready? That is what? Are you ready to face the reality of what you have learned? Because if not, and why not? If you fail to face the reality in this world, you may not be able to face the reality again in the new world, in the next world to come, until Jesus comes. Facing the reality now will take you to your destination. Facing what? The present situation is what will actualize your destination. So henceforth from now, what happened to you is nobody's fault anymore, but you and yourself. And that I'm going to split it again. What happened to you spiritually, in particular, whatever happened to you in particular spiritually, henceforth from today, it's nobody's fault anymore. It's nobody's judgment anymore. It's you. You got to decide your spiritual life from today. Do you want to follow men? Do you want to follow God? Do you want to follow men of God? Do you want to follow Christ? Are you willing to apply your lesson to change your world and adjust spiritually, physically, and medically, or politically? Are you ready? Spiritually, as I repeated, are you ready to face spiritual reality? Or you are still sleeping in spiritual illusion? Revelation chapter 3 verse 11 says, "Behold, I come quickly, and I hold fast with thou hast, that no man take thy crown." And verse 23b say, "And I will give unto every one of you according to your works." So therefore, I'm challenging you and I'm asking you, wake up and face the spiritual reality from today. Leave every human doctrine alone for now and face Jesus Christ alone before it is too late. Face Jesus Christ. The time is so short now. Pastor, what are you saying? You need to decide from today. What is your next spiritual status? To follow men, to follow Jesus. I will follow Jesus. I will follow Jesus. Wherever he goes, I will follow. It's time for you to search for Jesus yourself. Search for him if you know him. If you find him, follow him. Check scripture and balance yourself with whatever men tell. Whatever I'm telling you now, If they are not convincing to you spiritually, delete me. But I'm telling you today, face reality of your life spiritually. Face reality. Before I end, I remember in the beginning of the year, 2020, the Lord spoke to me that this is our year of kingship authority, our year of the shift, a year of the war. So let me remind you of this prophetic alert and warning that we received on the 4th of March, on the 1st of March 2020, before the lockdown in Africa. I want to remind you quickly right now, the prophetic focus of the year, in the beginning of the year, when the Lord spoke to us that this year 2020 is a year of war. And we have seen the war that has been happening globally, the virus, the COVID-19 war, which brought us war to a lockdown, a global lockdown. In the beginning of the March 2020, the first day of March, before even any African nation was locked down, the Lord spoke to me prophetically and warned the nation that that month was going to be famine. Bread will be scarce, water will be scarce, even toothpick will be scarce, but it doesn't make any sense to us because we never experienced what is called global lockdown in our own generation. Until when the prophecy unfold itself. Hear it now. And stay tuned. I'll come back to you.
Now, what is the global prophecy for the year 2020? The Global Peace Accord. It's a year of rising and a year of falling. Hear me, it's a year of war. It is a year of war. Political war among nations, territory war among continents. Be writing it down. Listen to me. There are instruments of war already prepared, and that will be prepared for 2020. It's a year of war. Nations, continents. You will soon hear it now. You should be hearing the breaking news. People at war. 2020 is a year of oppression. 2020 International World Peace Challenges. It's a year of war and counter challenges. I see more outbreak of war, politically and economic rivalry. I see more and more territorial protection war arising from the Western world powers within themselves, particularly for America, Asia, Europe, and counterpart. Are you writing it down? 2020 is a year of the shift and transfer of power. It's going to be a shift in 28 years. A shift in the realm of the spirit. There's going to be a shift in the realm of power. Now, 2020 religion prophecy. There will be churches at war. I saw it. It was telling me. War among churches and religions in the land. Fight for territorial control will be much more rampant, particularly among the Christian, the charismatic churches. This is the year people must serve God and not men. Hear it? Serve God and not men. There will be so many religion war in the churches. And then, in the same year, 2020 is a year of Christian restoration. God will restore his glory in his kingdom to the church and genuine house of the Lord. While false and fake churches and fake acclaimed prophets of God, they will be exposed, they will be displaced around the world, particularly in Africa and every largest Christian countries around the world. The true children of God shall be free and they shall be established in their Christian dominion kingship. The secret of so many false prophets will be opened and their prayer will be free to their freedom. The house of the Lord shall yet be increased, and people shall worship God in truth and in spirit. 2020 global economy shift downline and upper line. It's going to be 2020 and 50-50 sharing economy. The year 2020 will be a year of economy transformation from the worst to the best. It is a year of balance. There shall be a periodic early season of a global financial crisis and famine, but the mid and later year of plenty and balance. Famine.
Hear me? This is a prophecy. There is going to be scarcity of bread in this land this month. Mark my word. You will hear breaking news. Amen. Scarcity of bread. Scarcity of essential commodities. And you will hear it in some part of Africa, in some part of Europe, in some part of Asia, not only in Africa. You shall hear the rumors. There's a scarcity of essential commodity. Even a toothpick will be so scarce in some part of this community, of this world. Hear me. God said to me, There is a shift.
This month. I'm not preaching though, I'm prophesying. It is a turning point. There is somebody hearing me from America, from Europe, from Asia, from China, from any part of the world, from Africa, every part of Africa. This month is your month of turning point. There is a shift. A dramatic shift.
So I'm giving you a spiritual warning. There is a scarcity. Water will be scarce. Even we are having, this is the season, I don't know, of millimi. Yet millimi will be scarce. But they will come to me and you.
Yes, sir.
How? Where are you getting your own millimi? Where? How are you getting your money?
Now you have seen it. You have heard it. You have seen the prophetic focus. You have heard it. I want you to decide. For the scripture say, for by their fruit you shall know them. So do not blame your spiritual what dryness, your spiritual gullibility on anybody anymore. Blame it on yourself after that you have had this. Why? Because you have failed to face spiritual, scriptural reality in your spiritual world. I will continue next Sunday on facing the reality in the present situation in order to arrive at your own destination. I believe you have been blessed. I believe you have been transformed. This word has blessed you and transformed you in the renewing of your mind. Therefore, I prophesy to you, you will make it in Jesus' name. As you go this week will be your week of reality in life. You will experience a new sources of peace, joy, happiness, and breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus. As this week break into a new month, you will break into a new destination in the mighty name of Jesus. Meanwhile, I want to invite you tomorrow, 6 p.m. Tomorrow is the 1st of June. So tomorrow we are going to be having prophetic watch hour of the month, where we will be declaring the prophetic word of the for the 6th month. I don't want you to miss this prophetic service, 6 p.m. South Africa time. This is where God will be speaking to us again, the purpose, the agenda for the 6th month, the prophetic agenda to every one of us and to the nation in the 6th month. Again, tomorrow time is 6 p.m. South Africa time. And please again, don't forget, and do you know that if you like our Facebook page, and if you click our YouTube subscription, you always be the